Action.
Action.
This story is called
Simba
and Yala
helped Bobo.
Just a minute. No, not him again. This story should be about me. Me, Scar! Get off.
Help!
Right. Simba and Nala help Bobo.
What? No! Get off!
Okay. Yes, Disney's Simba and Nala help Bomo.
Disney, get off!
Get him away. Okay, let's get started with the story. It was a hot day on the African plain. Zebras were grazing out on the green grass. Giraffes were searching the treetops for tender leaves. Elephants were returning from the waterhole. And Kula, the Cape Buffalo, had just awakened from his nap. It was time for lunch. None of the animals noticed little Simba. The lion cub was hunting. He crept up behind Kula. He pounced. Then Simba roared with all his might. But Kula never stopped eating. Simba didn't scare him one bit. In fact, none of the animals was afraid of the tiny lion cub. Simba, Kula said. It's too hot to play silly cub games. The buffalo swung his tail. And poor Simba was knocked to the ground. The little lion cub watched as the animals wandered off. How will I ever become a great king if no one is afraid of me? Simba wondered. Simba began to walk home. Suddenly he heard a familiar voice call to him. Simba, there you are! I've been looking all over for you! It was his best friend Nala. Do you want to play a game? She asked. No, said Simba. I don't feel like playing. Please, Nala pleaded. We could play tag. She continued. Or hide and seek? Or leapfrog? I said I don't feel like playing, Simba answered. What's the matter? Asked Nala. Are you feeling sick? No, replied Simba. But I'm tired of silly cubs games. I thought you liked games, said Nala. Not any longer, Simba sighed. No one takes me seriously. I'll never be a good Lion King, he added. Just then, the two cubs heard a strange noise. What's that? Asked Nala. I don't know, Simba answered. Let's find out. The two friends followed the noise. It led them to the edge of a muddy pond. Over here, Nala whispered. cubs crept closer and closer. They peeked through the tall grass and saw a baby elephant. The elephant called, "I'm stuck in the mud." "What happened?" Nala asked. "I wandered away from my mother. She told me to stay close to her, but I didn't listen. I didn't think I'd get into this mess," said the elephant sadly. Simba knew all about getting into trouble. He felt sorry for the baby elephant. "What's your name?" he asked. "My name is BOMO. Can you help me, please?" "Don't worry. I'm the future Lion King. I can get you out of the mud," Simba assured him. Simba and Nala tried pulling from behind. "Ouch!" "Nala," cried BOMO, cried. "That hurts!" They pulled and pulled, but BOMO didn't move at all. So, Simba tried pulling from the front. "Ouch! My trunk is long enough already," BOMO shouted. But he still hadn't moved. Then Nala had an idea. "Let's use that log to get BOMO out," she said. She said to Simba. The two cubs rolled the log to the edge of the pond.